and they feel a responsibility, and the buck stops with the president. And I think you heard him say that on Thursday when he spoke to the loss of life of these servicemen and women shortly after it had happened.
Earlier today, we brought you a report of the families, Gold Star families, who lost their family members in Afghanistan at Joe Biden's order and with Joe Biden's suicidal stupidity for how he left Afghanistan. We are going to see a lot more of this play out. Those families hated meeting Joe Biden. Even the ones who did meet him, many of them left the room. Many of them turned their back on Biden. But even those who did meet with him, they said that it was an embarrassment of a meeting, that Joe Biden was distant, and it seemed like he had just staged everything, and he only had like a minute to spend with every person. What a total jackass. Jen Psaki was asked about this, and obviously she ran for the hills and hid in a cave, just like the Taliban would want her to. Go ahead and check this answer out.
Going back to the president's meeting with the families of Dover yesterday, the sister of one of the Marines killed in the airport attack told the Post that the president's comments struck her family as scripted and shallow, and she said, quote, "You can't F up as bad as he did and say you're sorry. This did not need to happen, and every life is on his hands." So my question is, can you talk a little bit about how the president thought the meeting with the families went, and also what responsibility, if any, for these deaths does he think he bears?
Well, I think the president made clear, as the Secretary of State and our National Security Advisor made clear, that we're all responsible, and they feel a responsibility, and the buck stops with the president. And I think you heard him say that on Thursday when he spoke to the loss of life of these servicemen and women shortly after it had happened. It is certainly the right of any individual who met with the president yesterday to speak publicly about their experience, but I'm not going to speak about the president's experience beyond what I've said already.
Following up, you mentioned that the president absolutely plans to stay in touch with those families. Is there the possibility he may attend any funerals or speak at any funerals?
Well, I will say what's important to remember here is that this is the worst thing that's happened ever in the lives of these family members. And last Thursday or Friday was the worst day of their lives. And what role the president plays or doesn't play is probably not front and center for them. But he's only going to do things that are of comfort to the family, are supportive of remembering the lives that have been lost. And he's going to continue to look for ways to do that.